The defining feature of the Russian 1895 Nagant revolver is its gas seal. The cylinder moves forward, creating a seal between it and the barrel. All other revolvers have an open gap between the two that the bullet must jump through as it's fired, and they leak gases that could otherwise be used to drive the bullet out of the barrel. The Nagant bullet achieves higher velocity due to its gas seal that it otherwise wouldn't have. The unique ammunition certainly plays a role in creating the seal, but I'm most interested in the mechanics of how the cylinder moves forward. You can clearly see it working here, first in single action, and in double action. And you can move it back and forth by hand. There's a spring inside of the cylinder pin which biases it backwards. But how does the cylinder get pushed forward before firing, creating the gas seal? Let's take a look inside. With the side plate off, here are the typical revolver parts: the hammer, trigger, mainspring, hand, and the double action sear. These parts here are what set apart the Nagant. There's this part called the camming block that slides up and down in a track cut out in the frame. And then this part, the support block, that pivots back and forth on this pin here. As the camming block slides up, it interacts with the support block, camming it forward. Back in the revolver, we can see how that works. Here I'm helping it out by pushing the cylinder, but with the support block all the way forward, the cylinder still needs to move forward more. So how does that work? I'll put the trigger back in. This extension on the trigger goes into the notch cut out in the camming block. This is what moves it up and down as the trigger is pulled. I have to hold these parts together with my finger so they don't pop out of place, but you can see the hand engaged in the ratchet teeth on the cylinder. As the hand moves up, it fits through this notch in the frame, which due to its shape and the hand shape biases it forward, which in turn pushes the cylinder forward the rest of the way. Here it is with a side view, and you can see the gap between the cylinder and the support block. So why is that there? Let's get a piece of brass and rotate it into position. We can see that the gap is for the proper headspace between the cartridge and the support block, which is what takes the brunt of the forces when a round is fired. The camming block's track being vertical makes it so the support block cannot be pushed backwards until the trigger is released and the support block drops down, allowing the camming block to move back. In conclusion, both the support block and the hand are used in conjunction to push the cylinder forward, but the delicate hand, which is directly connected to the trigger, doesn't bear much of the forces, if any. And that's how the Russian 1895 Nagant revolver and its gas seal work. Thanks for watching.